YouTube channel already up and running. Win J's Smoke Shop, the podcast. I just haven't posted.
Hey, man, we at work. About to do another episode. Smoke Shop. Y'all see Wayman ass over there? Bane's Corner. Actually, we kind of don't, bitch. This is the one time he's blacker than me. One time he blacker than me, mother.
You know, it's funny. Because a lot of niggas can't do time. Like, you can do time, but the stress, you can't let shit get to you.
I can't do time.
Some people, like, when you got a lot of shit going on, you really can't. Like, you got to be a whole different nigga up here.
Right.
Because you will be behind that wall whooping on niggas' asses. Spazzing on niggas cause you locked up. You can't get out though. And it's hard to do shit when you locked up. You think you got a motherfucker on your team that's dependable? That bitch gonna show you every reason why she's not dependable. I mean, every reason. You calling this bitch on the phone with her like you said you was just about to go do this, bitch. Normally you don't be doing nothing every fucking day. Now all of a sudden you got a million things to do.
Yeah, that's the hardest thing about it is when you just used to being in control of everything. Like, you been in control of everything, and all of a sudden you don't control nothing no more. That's the most fucked up feeling about being locked up. You feel me? Like, damn, I move this way, I move that way. Nah, I can't move that way. Nah, I gotta listen to what a bitch say.
Yeah.
I wanna eat food. Normally, I wanna eat. I gotta depend on the next bitch to bring me food. My money. That ain't, you know what I'm saying? Everything turned into you ain't a grown man no more. They took that grown man responsibility from you. You can't even go piss when you want to, you feel me?
That's
so
crazy.
You gotta think of it like that. Like, that shit really hit me different. Like, I gotta depend on other people in order for me to eat while I'm in this bitch.
Alright, so you basically being emasculated, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
Right.
You getting that, you got a person that can be 10 times younger than you, just telling you
what the fuck you do.
When to wake up. Going through your belongings, you know what I mean? And depending on their personal life, they gonna bring that and it's gonna run over into your life. But you ain't nothing but a number now, so it's they life.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The part about, like, the streets, like, a lot of dudes do a lot of shit in the streets, but they don't understand that other side of that wall, that movie shit, that movie shit ain't shit. Probably the only thing about Shawshank Redemption that was like on point is when them boys now on that shit.
But it'll rape you, but
it'll get on you like that if you in there and you got that scent on you. You know what I mean? That shit is wild like that.
I saw a nigga get fucked with a broomstick.
Damn.
I don't know about all that, but
I'm happy. I ain't, like I said, I ain't never been in prison. I've been in jail, but I ain't never had to experience all that. But the most fucked up thing is I just never understood how niggas could keep doing the same thing and really missing their kids' birthdays. Like, how niggas missing your kids' birthdays and missing these holidays and they hitting y'all. Niggas sitting here ganging, talking about gang, but they ain't realizing you ain't getting none of these days back. You know what I'm saying? That's right. Why niggas ain't really... Being locked up saved me in a sense. You know what I'm saying? It made me really understand that it only took me one time. You know, I got a million kids, but I ain't never missing no kids' birthdays. When I finally missed my kids' birthdays and it was something I couldn't control, it hurt me as a man. You know what I'm saying? One of my first days being locked up, not even my first day, my first week, my youngest son called, when I called my phone, he was like, man, dad, I'll go to sleep early. I promise I'll do better on my homework. You know, just come home. You know, I'm sorry. And that shit really hit me that you don't understand as a man how I feel. Got on other people's life if you actually involved on the outside.
Yeah.
And
like
being around a lot of niggas who sweat their jeans and niggas who sweat you got recognition, I ain't respect nobody in there
none
who wasn't talking about they weren't missing their children.
Yeah.
They weren't missing the lives of their kids.
You know what, bro? You know,
that's crazy.
That's what hit me as like, you're
old,
you're a real nigga.
Yeah, I felt that same way when I would talk to dudes. They come chop it up with me. And I would just kind of, it would be like a placebo test. I just see, like, how long, how many days I'm going to talk to you before you bring up your children.
Your kids.
And I'm like, hey, boy, you got kids out there? Yeah, I got.
The kids don't even respect.
It's like, no, man, because I know you can't tell it to me if you ain't the first thing you got. Family got to be first.
Yeah, or you got that one dude like me sometimes, like, it'd be like 2-3 days out of the week. I just take a few hours at the time. I'm on my bunk. I don't be bothered. I'm just looking at my kids. I'm writing letters to them because That was my time for them. You feel me? To write them letters. Even though I know, if, you know what I'm saying, they don't read it, they don't get to see it, they don't get it when I want them, but that's when I was in prison, and see, like, it's, that's what really changed me, because that phone conversation I had with my daughter before I got shipped, yeah, that shit broke me.
And see, that's broke how, me. That's how calm I was, like, when I got in trouble, I ain't never been in prison. I caught my leg in the day, and I know I had to do 8 months. It ain't really killing me that I had to do the time. So you could prepare mentally, but you got to do the time. But you can't prepare, like, the unexpected, how your kids gonna handle things.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You can't prepare yourself for by reality. You're not finna see them. If it's stupid junk, like, what if somebody jump on my kids while I'm locked up? What if my kids get hit by a car? You don't wanna think that way, you know what I'm saying? But just, what if something happened? It's like, damn. You know what I'm saying? I done figured out my chick was cheating, fucking on me. I didn't give a fuck that. You know what I'm saying?
How my kids doing, bitch?
How my kids? You know what I'm saying? I don't care about a nigga want to make more money or use it. That's cool. But my kids, I can get money back. I'm always better for a cold, that's me. But I ain't gonna be able to get my 13-year-old birthday back. You feel what I'm saying?
That's real.
I ain't gonna be able to get the 16-year-old birthday. Or I miss his graduate. Now I miss his prom. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna have him spit for him the way he wanted to get his skirt down cologne game, right? Because I'm over there doing stupid shit.
So I have a question. So when you realize that, you know, when you did wrong in order to make it right, when you first got out, what was the first adjustment?
My first adjustment, personally, I wanted to personally try to get a job because I always hustle. I never had a job. I'm 38 years old. Shit, I only had one job in my life. Yeah, so I'm 38 and I had one job. I always hustle. I always got money. You know what I'm saying? But the bad thing is, my kids always see me because I raised them, I got custody. So they always see me that, even though I tell them, don't do this, don't do that. Hey, look, my nigga, we gonna be here, pussy gonna be here. We grown from our pussy, grown from our, don't fuck up school for that. You gonna know that. But if they see their daddy clean and selling drugs, they know what's going on. I can't hide work, I can't hide pounds. They can hide them, they look, they getting 16 and 15 and 14. They,
see, yeah, all grabbing
green. Not even hit you. I'm in the car with them some days. I'm trying to be slick and hop out the car with a bag. And they know what's going on. And finally, when I do get jammed up, now we had a hard talk. Their mama's OGs. They all, I'm a baby mama's OGs. So we all keep it real with each other. So, yeah. So when I got out, I wanted to really show them, like, it was a different way of hustling. That's why I love having my job now, because I want my kids to see that it's another way of living, my nigga. Like, you can work up and be square, you can wake up every day and you can really get it, dog. You really focus, like, you determine yourself. So I had to let them see that, like, ain't nothing wrong with hustle. Don't get it twisted. That's what you gotta do at the end of the day. Okay, fuck, daddy hustled, my grandpa hustled, it's in our DNA. But being a hard working man, I want to show them that was in our DNA too. That's why.
I'm gonna be honest with you.
What you want to do, man? Tell the truth.
First time you got out. Oh, first time I got out, I ate a Whataburger and got some pussy. That was my routine. Number one, no pickles, weak cheese, large fry, Dr. Pepper.
First
and day. I'm tearing somebody that daughter up, okay. Ass up.
Okay.
You first night.
So let me be honest, too. Yeah. Let me be honest.
I've been arrested 36 times. So I had a ritual.
Okay, now let me be honest. Let me be honest, too, right?
Yeah.
I'm talking to all this good daddy shit, right? But I gotta be a nigga for 5 minutes, be real. I ain't even tell my kids when I first got out. My first 3 days, I ain't tell my kids all my baby mama. Boy, I wouldn't have.
You got to.
I had to get me by 3 good me days.
You got to.
I didn't lie. I had some shit waiting out of town, you know what I'm saying? I don't even my due date. My release date said like the 11th. I got out like the 5th. I'm like, I ain't gonna cap. Niggas had to go straight down, so.
You know what?
Kill some shit.
You know what? It won't hurt me now to tell the truth. So the last time I got out of jail, I didn't tell my baby mama the exact day. I didn't tell nobody the day. I told them I got out on the next day. Because I had a bitch named Ashley come pick me up. And it was over with. Like,
what a joint.
This one right here. Oh, Rodney put it right down. You know, Rodney tap out quick. Rodney G tap out quick. What's the wildest thing you ever saw while locked up, while incarcerated? What's like one of the wildest things y'all ever saw? We'll start over here with Woo. Woosie.
All type of shit. Niggas strapping smoke sausage around their waist. Around their waistband with the saran wrap. You know, they sneaking this shit across the yard trying to get back in the cell block. They had to pass it over to somebody. He got to get it and get it chopped down before You know what I mean? The goulash get put together at night. Like, shit is like, it's so systematic all the way down to the letter. You know what I mean? I done seen the boy, he and now with the, this the major's nephew. He and now with the boy in the little church hall.
With the pump.
He and now got him on the piano. CO's done coming down, they say, back up out of it. Back up out of it. This is the CO. They tell us this. Like, you know, they were basketball shit, man. We on the team in the basketball. My own girl, they CO, they chopping it up with us. I said, no, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's some crazy shit, dog. That shit had you lost some words, man.
Man, I've seen some wild shit. County and prison. I don't even know what's. I just seen grown men having sleepovers. In the county. But I just see grown men swapping rooms like it's Motel 6 in that bitch. Like, I'm gonna sleep in your room tonight. Hold up, bro. Why are you sleeping in that grown man room tonight?
I'm gonna tell you some shit, though.
And the CO walk by and be like, oh, where your bunk at? Over there. I ain't even worried about it.
Down in the Gulf, we on the yard finna go to the canteen. Lying Long is a Jesus concert. This one nigga, he talk a lot, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He a funny nigga. So he done ease his way, you know, he strolling though, but he get the white boy, bum, bum, bum. You know what I mean? His whole disposition got him like, he in there. He slip up a little bit more. He done got in front of this one nigga dog. Out of nowhere, bow, dead on the sand. I said that shit crazy, man.
Yeah,
I tell you, but that's just one. It's another thing about prison. Like that shit just ain't. It ain't for the people.
It ain't for the lighthearted. I can tell you that much. Hey, this is an episode of ITen Win present Smoke Shop. We talking real talk. Bring your toilet paper, cause we talking shit tonight.
I done ran into some racks, I done ran into your girl. Why the plug show me love? I done came up on my dub. Plug up.